So, Nadine Voss.
Don't talk to me.
I was gonna say, you look good.
Was that not clear? What's that smell?
Oh, I'm sorry. I haven't exactly had access to running water and soap recently. All the people you could have brought with you.
She saved my ass more than once, you know.
You do remember that, she also tried to kill Nathan and I many, many times.
And to be fair, you two tried to do the same to her.
Yeah, but that's not the point. The point is that the second we turn our backs, there will be a knife in there.
I can hear every word you're saying.
I know!
I trust her.
You know what? Fine. I guess I'm just a little bit irked that we are walking away with nothing. But I guess you know what that's like, right?
Oh, my.
Real classy, thank you.
Time and place, children. More that came from.
Bike racks after school.
Just hurry up.
Appears the kings have one final test.
Looks like you won't be needing us, though, so we'll just be on
our way. On the contrary. Surely you know the story. You see, Shiva gave Parashuram the mighty axe that struck Ganesh in the face, bringing Shiva's son, one of the greatest of the gods, to his knees. Another casualty of war.
Don't.
Seriously, Chloe, he's just gonna kill him!
He's right. But if you refuse, you will watch them die, inch by inch.
All right!
Chloe, don't!
Parashurama. Parashurama and Ganesh. What now?
Chloe, don't you give this schmuck what he wants.
Quiet.
You're testing my patience.
Quiet!
Ganesh, quite an obstacle you've placed in my path.
Chloe, you sure that's it?
No. An obstacle you've placed in my path.
you all right?
Here. That was unexpected.
Holy shit, she's got balls, huh?
I don't understand.
It's an idiot.
That's because you've got it all twisted, my friend. Ganesh allowed himself to be struck by the axe.
That makes no sense.
Not to a selfish prick, no. You see, Ganesh could have defeated Parashurama easily. But if he had, that would have made Shiva's axe look weak. Powerless.
Ganesh sacrificed himself to preserve his father's honor.
See, even she gets it, not a drop of Indian blood in her.
Magnificent, isn't it? Oh, what? Nothing to say now?
Oh, if you like, I can tell you where to stick it.
Well, my friends, I would love to kill you myself, but you must not anger the gods, for you have brought me a great fortune.
Okay, then what are you doing?
I'm going to flood the chamber.
I will miss you.
Come on, is this really necessary?
You know, nothing is ever truly destroyed, only purified and reborn.
Just shoot us and get it over with.
Right.
As the water fills your lungs, you will have time to reflect on the choices that brought you here. Perhaps in your next lives, you will fare better.
Frick.
I don't know about you guys, but I got a lot of regrets swimming around in my head right now.
Tell me about it. I was really looking forward to kicking your ass again.
Hey, you know, I'm not exactly thrilled about drowning next to you either.
Could you give it a rest, guys? I'm trying to concentrate.
What are you doing?
A little preparation goes a long way.
Haha, yes!
I gotta quit smoking.
Stop! Think they saw us?
I don't know.
How the hell did Asaf get that helicopter?
Maybe it's the bias.
What do you mean?
Just overheard Asaf talking about end of the old rail yard, something about an arms deal.
He's selling the Tusk.
So much for preserving his culture.
Hey, just a second. Listen, back there. Thanks for...
Professional courtesy.
Of course. So, are we good?
No.
I figured.
If we hurry, we can intercept them before they make the sail. Huh. And there's our ride.
Railroad tracks.
Stop here.
The Sov will have lookouts throughout the area. Vistor on the side of caution.
Right. And then we lose the Tusk.
You're welcome to stay behind.
I'm just saying.
Right. Less talking, more walking.
So all that time in a Sov's care and you couldn't get any intel on the bias?
Well, I tried. You saw the cagey one. Almost never talk shop in front of me.
Can't imagine why.
Hey, he trusted me enough to believe I was an expert in all this hoist-a-law crap.
Hoist-a-law?
Yeah, that too.